Hello, hello, hello. We live, we here. How's it going, Incorporation Nation? It's your boy, Zakanzu. What's the scene before us? Could it be that in my absence, I kept working on the library while I was, unable to connect to the internet? Indeed, I did. Look at this thing. It's done. I did it. Not bad, I gotta say. So, I'm just gonna do some... Whoa! Some highlights. So, first off, like, some of the pages have sheet music on them, which is pretty cool. You can see the books look like books now. Incredible. They're also all different colors. I actually figured out how to make them all different colors, but they're all the same material. So they're all this book RGB material, but it's really a noise material that changes the color. And I just made it really big so that each color value is slightly different. Just like in the real book, well, I say the real bookshelf, but you know, the normal background, we've got SpongeBob and the mask from JoJo, which does have fangs, as you can see, but they're very subtle. I also tried my hand at sculpting with this teddy bear here. So cool. His name's Fred. And then we've got a treasure chest and the stand arrow and a master sword. I did finally figure out how to make the Skyrim helmet. Close enough. Pokeballs, no faces mask. We made the chess pieces on stream, do you remember that? But look at this. Like, let's just observe. Here's the things that I made on stream. You know, they're all right. But that was when I was just using object mode for everything, I think. Now, look. Yes, a proper Triforce. Using edit mode. Mm-hmm. But we're gonna keep the object mode stuff in here because, you know what? It's got character. Character, I say. Character! Oh, and I made the portal gun. Look at that. How cool. Portal gun. How does he do it? And of course, I made these chairs. Look at them. They're just like the chairs in the the normal thing. Although, you know, it doesn't quite line up the way that I thought it would. I tried to make this chair look realistic, but it turns out like the arms are very low compared to the back, in contrast to the drawn version. But that's okay. We can look at it from the front and it looks fun. And then I put a little light bulb in the lamp, which I thought was really cool. Yeah. But let me just save this. This is not what we're doing today. No, no, no. Today, we are going to... But you can open up multiple Blender windows. That sounds dangerous. We're going to go back to our guy. Remember this guy? Of course you do. nothing between you and me since we made this guy. But here he is. Put him into darkness. Didn't he look sad? He does, doesn't he? There we go. Just make this viewport bigger for our purposes. Ugh. There we go. Yeah. Okay. So today we're gonna take our guy, our little guy here. We're gonna give him skeleton bones, real bones. And I remember the first time I gave something bones, it didn't turn out too well, actually. In fact, it kind of turned out horribly. Because we accidentally duplicated the bones too much. He had a powerful amount of bones. So today, we're going to follow this tutorial by our boy, Joey Carlino, until we're absolutely sure. Absolutely sure. That we get it right. Let's get started. Joey Carlino, give me the
And this one will be rigging the character we made in a previous video, so if you want to follow along, you should start with that one. Here's a summary of what I'll cover in this video. First, I'm going to prepare our model for rigging by adding in more loop cuts at bending spots, like the elbows and knees, making sure our mesh is dense enough, and also moving some things around to avoid complicated weight painting later on. Next, we'll start creating our armature while I go over some of the viewing options and basic rigging concepts, like bone relationships, bone roll, and naming conventions. Once we make all the deforming bones, I'll move on to creating some simple IK controllers and other bones that make posing our character more fun and easy. After that, I'll use the simple renaming panel add-on to rename our bones, so when we copy them to the other side, they all have the proper names. This
simple renaming panel, huh? Is that a add-on? Rename. Nope. Let's see if our boy, simple renaming panel, yes. Beautiful. A fair price. Oh, right, I have to enter my email. I remember how Gumroad works. God, I'm not human. You have to believe me when I say I'm not a computer. I'm not a computer. Okay, cool. Simple renaming panel 2.0 download the zip file. Open the zip file. How do I, read me? Uh-huh. Yes, but how do I install? I don't need the old versions. I just need to go back to here. See if it tells me how to install. Home overview. Home. Hello, Matthias. Here we go, download installation. Okay, sick. So, this is my first time adding a custom add-on. Let's make a new folder for add-ons in my Blender folder. Because this is going to get complicated soon. All right. Oh, do we knock out here? We did. Well, VOD users, welcome to the exclusive content. Hello. Sorry for stream scuff. It's okay. All we're doing is installing an add-on. So, file. File. Edit. Preferences. Hello? I think we're back. Yeah. Install. Install add-on. Uh-huh. Simple. It didn't, yay, I'm back. Hi. I'm trying to install this file. Can we drag it in? Is that easier? Ooh. Anyway, yes, I'm back. Like, for real back. Yeah! Look at that. I've added the simple renaming panel. Okay, that was way easy. All right, good. Boom, boom. Back to the tutorial. Hello, Golmaal. How are you? It's been so long. But really, it feels like not that long because nothing has happened in the past month. For me, too. How's your past month been? For me, it's like nothing has happened. Like nothing has happened. And yet, so much has happened. All right.
Might seem like a small detail, but I'll explain why it's actually a big deal. With our armature completed, we can parent our character to it to make it deform. We'll touch up some spots with weight painting, and we'll finish off by talking about posing a little. As always, I'll try to address common problems along the way, and before we get started, I'd like to mention that I don't consider myself an expert when it comes to this stuff. I'm still very much in the process of getting better with character modeling, rigging, and animating, so expect more videos on this in the future. I've watched a bunch of tutorials on these topics, digested them, mixed concepts together, and experimented a lot. to get to the point where I feel like I can actually explain this to you. If you're interested in the videos that helped me out, I put a short list in the description. All right, let's get started. All right, so here we are in Blender 2.92, and we have the character here that we modeled in a previous video. So first, I am just going to set a few things up. First thing I am going to do is switch into solid mode right here. And I'm also going to get rid of these colors by clicking this button right here and going to object right here. So now everything's just gray. And I also want to turn wireframe on over here under overlays. You can just check this box right here and you can change the opacity a little. I'm just going to turn
wireframe. Oh my goodness, that looks scary all of a sudden. Opacity. Well, that's better.
Around halfway like that, so we can see all of our points. Next thing I'm going to do is go over here to render properties, and down under simplify I'm going to turn this on and change the max subdivisions to 0.
Okay, render properties, simplify, turn this on, max subdivisions to 0. Oh goodness.
And so basically what this is doing is looking at anything that has a subdivision surface modifier and making it so that in the viewport, when you're looking at it, it is not active. I click on the vest right here and go over to modifier properties. It's kind of like coming over to the subdivision surface modifier and making it so that you can't see it in the viewport, but it's doing that for like everything in the scene. I like doing this for a few reasons. One is because it speeds up your viewport. One other reason is that when we get to the point where you actually parent your character to an armature and it sets all of the weights automatically, the weights that it uses are from the original like vertex data before the subdivision surface modifier. So I like to know, especially when you're weight painting, where all of the original points are, and it's pretty easy to just toggle on and off like this. The next thing I'm going to do is straighten this arm out right here. And this isn't 100% necessary. You can totally rig it with it bent like this. But when I tried that, I was running into a few problems where when you straightened it out, it wasn't really deforming in a very clean way. And so to avoid complicated weight painting, I think it'll just be better.
What's up, Ray? Thank you for the badum-tish. I honestly thought that was in the video. Like, what's happening? God. How are you? Now that I'm not karaokeing, I can talk. What's new? You've been doing so much stuff in the past month. I've been doing nothing. It's been so long since I've seen this place. I know. We're back somehow. Somehow we've returned. But it's good to be back in the chair, you know? Good to be, feels comfy. And look, I've got a little thing that tells you what song is playing right now. Currently it's Theta's song, Lute. Whatever that means. We're just looking at our guy. Do you remember this guy? Might be easier when he's got colors, but you know, we're turning him into a model. Nothing my ass. You still managed to make some bangers like the comic and short songs, I guess. All right.
To straighten this out. And it's pretty easy too. We can just select our mesh, go into edit mode right here with tab. And basically what I'm going to do is start deleting loops in between here where it bends. So I'm going to make sure I'm in face select mode right here, or you can hit 3 and hit Alt Shift and you can start selecting loops like this. I'm just selecting ones that are not really very parallel like that. And once I have all these selected, I'm just going to delete them like that. I can select this piece right here with L, and I'm just going to rotate this and try to make it so it's kind of straight along with this part. And so it might be easier if I turn on X-ray right here, and I'm also going to go into edge mode. And I'm basically just going to compare the two center lines like that. Just move it around until you get it close. So that...
Okay, all right, well, so I think I gotta take his jacket off. He looks so naked now. We just gotta straighten out this arm here. I'm the one who hasn't made anything. I had a creative block, and I'm not in the mood to make something poggers. Aw. But you are poggers. You can make poggers. You can be poggers. You don't have to make poggers things. Okay, edit mode. Alright, definitely all these need to be deleted. And then let's see. We want to move this. We want to move this up here. X-ray mode. X-rated mode. Rotate on the Y. So we're like just about right. Right? Besides that, I've been sharing and writing notes of audio production, video editing. I've been teaching my friends about it too. Hey, teaching is a good way to learn, to solidify your skills. And make sure you know what you're doing, you know? Looks good.
It is pretty close. Then I'm just going to put it over here. So I think that would be a good length for the arms right there.
All right, our rotation is good. Now we just move this out. Yes.
So I'm going to come in again in edge select mode right here. I'm going to Alt Shift and click to grab this edge loop right here and also this one right there, and right click, and I want to choose bridge edge loops, and that should connect these.
Oh, nice. Bridge edge loops. That's a new tool for me. Very cool. Okay, edge select mode. Select. Bridge edge loops. Sounds lovely. I also found out what's causing my electric static noise on my XLR mic. It's caused by high electric output. Interesting. Yeah, it's so one of the things that they teach you in what's it called? Audio engineering is that power and signal don't mix. So all my signal is currently running through my microphone cable, which is very far away from anything that has to do with power. It does require like legitimately reorganizing your desk space, but it's so worth it.
Two parts. Then I'm going to use Control R to add in a loop cut, so that these face sizes are more consistent. So I think that will be okay. Okay, now that I did that, I am going to add some loop cuts where the joints should be. So I'm gonna put them for the elbows, the shoulders, and the knees. Just going to figure out where I should put the elbow. Maybe the...
Okay, those look consistent. Should we also... Should we also straighten out the arm outward like he's got? I think so. And then just select the rest of the hand. Okay. Rotate along the X, no, along the Y. Let's rotate along active element. Activate that part. Let's see how this works. Not too bad, actually. let's just move this a little bit out. How's that look? Pretty good? Pretty good? Okay.
This loop right here. So I'm just going to select that and Control B to bevel. And you can use the scroll wheel on your mouse to add in more loops like that. I'm just going to space it apart. That looks good. Go into X-ray mode with Alt Z. I'm going to add one in right here too. So I select that, bevel again, and just make sure you don't have the points overlap because it'll mess things up quite a bit. So I'm just going to get it close.
All right, where's this guy's elbow at? Here-ish? Seems about right. It annoyed me for a while because I was trying to solve the issue until I tried recording on my phone and no electric static noises. Yeah, that's a good way to test it. I was actually thinking about doing some streaming on my phone as well. Just because even though my internet is cutting out, the data on my phone is kind of like a backup internet, right? So I could elbow. That one. There we go. There we go. I can kind of stream less interrupted. But I haven't really figured out a good way to stream from my phone. I know there's apps, and I know Twitch and YouTube have their own like streaming things, but like what? How do I VTube? I want to VTube. My laptop has a broken battery, so I took it out and to keep it plugged in, which gives constant electric energy. Makes it pretty audible for the microphone. Yeah. You have to keep the audio cables and the electric cables as far apart as possible. And that's just a reality, I guess. Where am I putting this bevel? It's so audible you could hear the static flooding. Dang. That would be annoying as hell. All right. I think we need to add a loop cut here. But we can't bevel it very much. That's what I'm looking for. There we go. Some nice armature. Not even the headphones, like I connected everything, but when I speak, I hear the laptop buzz. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's due to, whatchamacallit, power, right? It's trying to send signal.
That should be good. And I'm also going to do the same thing for the knee. Hit 3 on the numpad to look on the side. And
that looks like a knee, don't you think? Bevel that shit.
I'll just bevel that also. So that looks okay. So I'm just gonna hit tab to go back into object mode, and I'm going to select our vest right here. So what I'm going to do next is take our vest and make it more dense.
We need to update the vest too, because now the vest needs to have its arm, or the jacket needs to have its arm straight up. Guess I need to find a way to suppress the electric stuff because the charging port is next to the USB port, which is pretty messed up. Yeah, so that's where those, like the XLR connector or audio interface things can really help, because it moves the microphone cable away from the power cables. But obviously that's not as good of an option if you don't have that, right? What the hell am I selecting? Why is this vest so thick? Just give me, yes, the edge. What am I selecting here? Oh, it's got the solidify modifier on it. Right. Let's turn that off real quick. Then I can see what I'm doing. There we go. I have this XLR to 3.5 millimeter to connect my sound card. Even if I put my mic far away, the buzz is still audible. Oof. I don't know, man. It's hard to, you know, analyze that sort of stuff from across the world. We're gonna have to bevel the elbow and shoulder on the jacket as well, aren't we? Yes, I think we are. So let's. Engineering, one hell of a subject to get into, for sure. Have you been looking into any of those courses though, yet? Rotate on the Y. I remember we were talking about those. It does not look bad. Except for the fact that it does look bad, you know. Turn on my solidify modifier. Turn off my simplify. Okay, it really doesn't look bad. Haven't tried yet, but they seem great. Yeah. Well, I find that the difference between people who, you know, find that like satisfaction in their life versus don't, is you really have to be willing to try new things, right? Let's just straighten out this. Scale it down to a reasonable size. Move it. That looks good. Solidify. Simplify. Yes, 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 yes. Okay. Then we need to bevel this. Quite a bit around the elbow. And then, actually, this point should be able to come in, right? Give me a cleaner vest. Give me a cleaner jacket. Take me to the cleaner. I'll be sure to explore more. Focusing lately on writing my story. It's a fan flick. It's a fanfic. Man, a fan flick would be like a fan movie. That would sound cool. It reflects my adventures on SMPMN. Very cool. Man, fanfic is so underrated. We've gone dark again. Dear VOD watchers, welcome to the secret part of the stream where I talk to you very directly. Oh, we're back. Kind of. Bleh. It always connects to the chat room first. Because the chat room is just like, is the internet connected? Does the internet do a connect? But then OBS streaming struggles a little harder, I think. OBS. And I understand why they don't want to like constantly be overloading like Twitch servers with reconnection efforts. But like, please. Okay. Let's turn off the simplify or the solidify. Okay. Disconnection. Yeah, it's gonna happen. That's why I'm doing it this way. You know, it's why I'm doing a tutorial today, because right now the disconnect is strong, and I don't want to be caught in a game, you know, when my internet's not working. God, look at the ears. They look very messed up without the simplify, the simplification thing.
And when I say dense, what I'm doing basically is looking for the sizes of the faces. So you can see, if you look at the wireframe of our vest, this face is really big right now. And if we compare that to the size of our faces on our body, they are very different. So I am basically just going to try to get them to be close to the same size. Easy way to do that, because we already have a subdivision surface modifier on here. I'm going to select this, turn off simplify, and then with that still selected, go over here to modifiers, and I wanna turn off optimal display. And when you do that, it will allow you to see all of the faces that are actually being added by this modifier right here. Now that we have that, and we can actually see it, I'm just going to turn down the levels right here until the face sizes between the vest and the body are similar. So I think at around 2, they are pretty close. You can see a line right here for the body, right there. And if you compare that to the vest, they're pretty similar.
That looks pretty similar.
So once we have that, I'm just going to apply this right here. And if you want to smooth this back out, you can just add in another subdivision surface modifier on top. So I just hit Control 2 to add that in, and now it's a little smoother. Okay, so I'm just going to turn Simplify back on. One other thing we should do before creating the armature is we need to fix this foot right here. At first glance, you might...
Hold up. That doesn't look good. Okay. We need another modifier. What is it called? Subdivision surface. I mean, I don't hate that for the back of the jacket. but now our jacket sleeves are like, ooh, wiggity whack. Okay. Let's go into. One thing I learned about my new mic is that it didn't need a phantom power supply. Really? What am I selecting here? What the hell? Oh, right. I forgot. This is mirrored. We need to work over here. At least I have one in case I need one. Well, that's good. Like, it just needed a sound card and it was like a Vine Boom moment. It's working! All right. Grab Y. Just be straightened. There you go. And now we need to straighten the arm, because the arm has gotten unstraightened. In your anger, you unstraightened the arm. Okay. Just be normal. And then we need to scale this down. Yo, welcome, Seven. Hey, how's it going? What the heck? It's been so long. You're streaming Inscription. Hashtag Takagi. Welcome. I hope your stream went well. How was Inscription? That's a fun game. Some good strategy card game. / existential mystery. I don't know how far you're into the game, but it goes pretty deep, doesn't it? Oh, we're so close. Just a little bit sticking out here and there. All right, yes, so. Today we are doing Blender and also being very aware that the stream may drop in and out because my internet is not back. # we thought we were there, but we weren't. # sad times. # why are we here just to suffer? Look at this guy. # Takagi. Office man, he looks like he's on that Hotel Transylvania build. Oof. Yeah, see, now it's too far back. He's just too damn thick. And now we need to move the hand inside the sleeve. Are we fully in the sleeve? My God. We are fully in the sleeve. It's about damn time. I like this back to the jacket that was accidentally put here, but maybe it's a little bit too long. So can we just move this? In a bit, and this out of it. Oh, I see what's happening. My seams are showing. One thing I'm trying to do right now, I love hearing about what you're learning. One thing I'm trying to learn right now are harmonies and how to do a key change in the middle of the song if the keys are not in the same key area. I understand major plus major, but major plus minor feels hard. Let me just make this like... There we go. So, change keys in the middle of a song if they are not keys in the same key area. So essentially, you need a chord to bridge the gap. And what you can do is you can set it up so that you have a chord that still kind of fits in the key, in the first key, but pulls you towards the second key. And then because it's pulling you towards the second key, when you arrive at the second key, it doesn't feel as weird. But you do need that chord to kind of work in both keys. There's a name for it. Bridge chord, transition chord, something like that. It's been a while since I had anything at all. Are we even doing anything with this subdivision modifier? I don't think we are. Okay. Somehow things are working again.
Not notice what is wrong, but if we move the head right here, you'll see that it moves the foot also. And so if I were to rig this up, whenever we move the head,
what? Oh my god, he's right. Why?
Ed, the foot is going to move also, and we don't want that. The reason that is happening is because when we select our foot and we look at the mirror modifier, you can see that it's using the head as a mirror object.
Oh.
So I'm just going to clear that like this, and you can see it immediately messes our foot up. And that's because when you're not using a mirror object,
go to the shoes, go to the modifiers. Yep.
If you don't have one selected, it's looking at the origin point and using that as like the reference for where to mirror. So I just want to make sure our 3D cursor is in the center. And if yours isn't, you can hit Shift S, cursor to world origin, like that. And I'm just going to right click our shoe, set origin to 3D cursor. Now you can see it's mirroring based on the origin, but these are angled kind of weird. And that's because we don't have our rotation applied right here. So you can, you know, change that like this. If you wanted to clear it and just have your feet be straight, you could just hit Alt R like that. but I want our feet to be angled outward. I just like the way that looks, and I've rigged it before that way, and it worked fine. So to apply this, you would just hit Control A and apply rotation, and that will fix that for you and make it symmetrical. So with these things done, we can start setting up our armature. So I'm just going to hit 1 on our numpad to go to...
Oh my goodness. An hour in and we're finally ready to start putting the bones in. But I guess it's important to give this guy the bendy parts that he so desperately deserves. Look at his bendy parts. Could they be bendier? Yes. Will they? No. Don't worry about it.
Front view right here, and I'm gonna hit Shift A to add in an armature. I'm gonna.
Okay. Front view. Shift A. Add in armature.
Whoa. To single bone. So you can see it added a single bone in the center right here, but it's going through our character, so we should talk a little about viewing options. So with that selected, you can come over here to Object Data Properties. It looks like a little running person. And under Viewport Display, you have these display options. So you can change the shape of your bone right here. I'm gonna leave mine as octahedral. And you can also select in front. When you do that, this bone will always appear as if it's in front of your mesh. And nice. I'm gonna turn on axes and names. So now we can go into edit mode and we can start moving our bone around. So for this, I'm just gonna go into x-ray mode again. And I'm going to grab the head of our bone, which is the fat end, and the skinnier end is called the tail. And one thing to remember is when you're posing your character, it's always going to pivot from the head right here, and that'll come in handy more later. So I'm just gonna...
Let me just comprehend that. So this is the bone, here's the head, here's the tail, and we always pivot from the head. Okay. Interesting.
Grab the head right here and just pull that up right there. So like this is going to be near where our hips are. The tail I am going to put between the shoulders right there. And you can just hit.
Okay. So let's put the... that there. Can we select the tail? I've added, no, I'm moving the tie, shit. Bone. Make sure it's nice and centered. Ah, I see, you can scale it. That's what he's doing.
Hit E to extrude, and then Z to constrain on the Z axis. I'm gonna drag that up to...
Oh, look at that, look at that, okay. E to extrude. Constrain it on the z-axis, and we are in edit mode.
About the neck, and then E to extrude, Z to the top of the head, right there.
Mm-hmm. E to extrude, make sure I'm selected. E to extrude to the top of the head.
There. Going to add in our shoulder. That's going to go between those loop cuts that we made right there. I'm going to...
Okay, so we're selecting this, extruding, and we're trying to get it kind of on the x-axis here. But not quite. Just right in the middle of those loop cuts, huh? Pressing good to do the hands.
Extrude again to our elbow. Once again, between those loop cuts. Extrude again to go to where we want the wrist to bend. Okay, now we're going to work on the hand. We can just extrude that right there. This is going to control like our entire hand. So I'm going to extrude again and select this bone right here and hit Alt P. And I want to disconnect the bone like that.
Okay. Extrude here. Extrude here. And then Alt P. Disconnect.
So now you can see we can disconnect it. And if you look closely, there's this black dotted line, and that's a relationship line. That means that this bone is parented to this bone. So this is the child of that bone. And when you go into pose mode up here, what that means is that when you move the parent bone, the children of that bone are going to follow it like that. We'll go back into edit mode now. And I just want to place these for the fingers. And once again, remember that these bones pivot from the head. So you want to put these bones where the knuckles would go, like that. And you can just place this one at the tip of the finger. You can select it from the middle and hit Shift D to duplicate. And I'll just start placing these around where the knuckles would be. And then place the tails at the tip of the finger.
Okay, okay. Shift D to duplicate. Put them on the knuckles. We love knuckles. Oh, do we disconnect again? Bleh. I didn't even notice it that time. But maybe that's okay. Look at that. Skeleton, begin.
Like that. Take your time with this. You know, you don't have to rush. Duplicate this again for the thumb.
Who's rushing? I'm not rushing. Duplicate again for the thumb. Who's Russian? Not me. Not me, see?
And drag this over. Okay, that looks good. Now we can select all of these finger bones right here, and we can subdivide them by right-clicking and hitting subdivide. And I want the-
Oh shit, that's cool. Okay, yes. Select all, subdivide.
To be three bones each, so in this dialog box that popped up right here, you can just turn that up to two. So it's cutting it twice. We have three bones per finger. I'm going to do the same thing for the thumb, except I'm going to leave it as two bones. Okay, then I am going to select this spine right here and subdivide that once. Also, you can subdivide this more if you want to. Okay, next I'm going to work on the legs. So I'm going to grab this and extrude it to where I think the leg should bend, and then...
Ah, we're doing the thing where the hip is the... the base point, the base focal point.
And I'm going to extrude this down to the knee and look from the side so I can line this up properly. And extrude this down to where the bottom of the leg goes. Okay, then I'm going to extrude this to where the toe bends right there in the center, and another one for the tip of the toe. You might have to rotate this. You could.
Okay, all right. Extrude to the hip. Yes, good. Still. Extrude down to the knee. Extrude down to the foot. Oh. Let's put that right in line. And then we've got... take this, extrude down to toe bend, and extrude out to end.
Like I have been doing, just select each part and drag them over like that. Or another way to do it is select both of these bones like that. And you're gonna wanna make sure that this is the last one you select. You can see it's brighter. And you can hit period to change the pivot point to active element. And when you do that and rotate it, it will pivot at the head of the actively selected bone. Mm. And that just makes it easier like that. So.
Okay. Select these two bones. Make sure that is there. Pivot on active element. We're already doing that. Rotate on the Z. Just bring that right in line. Everybody get in line. He got bones.
These bones will still be straight. Another thing you can do is just select one of your bones and hit N to open the side panel. And under item, you have this length option, and you can do that to change the length. And you don't have to be in active object or active element mode for that. So now we have this bone right here that you can leave it there if you want to, but I don't really think it's necessary for our character specifically, so I'm going to delete it. Another thing is that this bone is not really parented to anything, and I want to parent it to this bone right here, this first spine bone. To do that, you would select the leg bone, then select the spine right here and hit Control P, and you want to choose Keep Offset. When you do that, you'll see that relationship line. If and...
okay. Control P. So now, select this, Control P, Keep Offset. Okay.
Instead, you did Connected. It will actually move the bone to make them connected, and obviously that messes up our skeleton, so I don't want to do that. Just make sure you use Keep Offset. So now I'm going to talk about axes, and this is the reason why I have the axes displayed, is because I like our x-axis right here. I like that to act as sort of a hinge that we know the joint will naturally pivot upon. You totally don't have to do this, but I think it is a good habit to get into, and it makes posing a lot easier. Because when you hop into pose mode, it allows you to just select any bone and know that it's going to act the way you want if you pivot it on the X axis. So you can just hit R and then X twice to go on the local axis, and it'll rotate along that axis right there. And you can see right now, this is not like natural leg movement. To rotate these, make sure you're back in edit mode. You can hit the N side panel right here, and there's this roll option. If you want to roll multiple bones at the same time, it's not enough to just select multiple bones and then drag this like that. Before clicking and dragging, you have to hold Alt first, and then when you do that, it will affect multiple bones. So basically what I'm going to do is select both of these bones right here, and I know I want them to pivot kind of where the Z axis is right now. What I'm going to do is just hit 7 to look from the top, and with both of those selected, I'm going to hit Alt and change the roll value so that the Z is kind of pointing towards the toe. I want to do the same thing for our foot right here. So I want it to pivot along this way, and I want the toe to also pivot that way. So I'm just going to hit 1 to look from the front and just roll both of these like that. And I'll tweak this one a little too. So now those are both flat along the X axis.
Okay, I don't really understand what he's doing, but I think it's important. We're blending. Okay, cool, cool.
Axis, like that. These ones look good. Let's see, that one should be pointing this way, so I'm just going to select all of these bones right here, and the hand bone too. Hit Alt and rotate all of these like that, so the X is facing us. Enough to just select multiple bones and then drag this like that before click offset.
Let's just
so now I'm going to talk about axes, and this is the reason why I have the axes displayed, is because I like our X axis right here. I like that to act as sort of a hinge that we know the joint will naturally pivot upon. You totally don't have to do this, but I think it is a good habit to get into, and it makes posing a lot easier because when you hop into pose mode, it allows you to just select any bone and know that it's going to act the way you want if you pivot it on the X axis. So you can just hit R and then X twice to go on the local axis, and it'll rotate along that axis right there. And you can see right now, this is not like natural leg movement. To rotate these, make sure you're back in edit mode. You can hit the N side panel right here, and there's this roll option. If you want to roll multiple bones at the same time, it's not enough to just select multiple bones and then drag this like that. Before clicking and dragging, you have to hold Alt first, and then when you do that, it will affect multiple bones. So basically what I'm going to do is select both of these bones right here, and I know I want them to pivot kind of where the Z axis is right now. What I'm going to do is just hit 7 to look from the top, and with both of those selected, I'm going to hit Alt and change the roll value so that the Z is kind of pointing towards the toe. I want to do the same thing for our foot right here. So I want it to pivot along this way, and I want the toe.
We've disconnected again, but let's just check out what he's talking about in pose mode. So this is really like rotate along the X, right? He wants any X rotation to be a natural foot movement, a natural body movement. The movement you'd expect, essentially. Okay. Yeah, that makes sense. Sorry about your internet tears. Oh, it sucks. I called the internet company and they're like, you need to reset your router. We've sent a test over to determine what's wrong and you need to reset your router. And I did. Nothing changed. So I need to call them again, but it's all in German, so it's annoying. Look at that. So this is why we rotate these axes. So that when can we turn off names just to make sure? Just want to see. Oh yeah, look at that. I guess that is the direction I would think that it moves. Uh-huh. Oh, it disconnected again. Damn you, ISP, damn you! Well, we knew this was going to happen. That's why I'm doing this. Just a nice, easy tutorial with so little stakes. The tutorial stakes are pretty low. That's why we're doing it.
To also pivot that way. So I'm just going to hit 1 to look from the front and just roll both of these.
You got to roll
like
them bones.
That, and I'll tweak this one a little too. So now those are both.
Yeah, I've been exploring more music. I'm wondering about what the best emotionally ambiguous chord progression ever. Something similar to what Porter does. I don't think Porter Robinson does emotionally ambiguous chord progressions. Nothing against his chord progressions. but I don't think that they are very emotionally ambiguous. Okay. Nodding. Shaking. Turning.
Flat along the x-axis, like that. These ones look good. Let's see, that one should be pointing this way. So I'm just going to select all of these bones right here. And the hand bone too. Hit Alt and rotate all of these like that. So the X is facing us. So now it should be easy enough to just hop into pose mode. And I know that when I rotate these on the X-axis, they're all gonna rotate the way I expect, like that. So next I'm going to run through and just name all of these bones that we created. This isn't something that is absolutely necessary once again, but I like to do it for clarity. So to name the bones, you can just select your bone and you can go over to this bone button right here, bone properties, and you can change the name up here. You can also do it in the outliner down here. I don't really recommend doing it this way, but you can do it over there. The way I like to do it is by selecting the bone and hitting F2, and then this name box pops up and you can just name your bone right there and hit enter. Okay, so I'm just gonna time lapse through this part while I name all the bones. And next thing we're going.
Okay, let's name the bones. Real big powerful hours here. Let's call this spine.01. What's this? Spine.02. This is obviously neck. This is id. This is shoulder. What do you call this part of your arm? Not the forearm, the upper arm, right? Let's just call it arm. And then this will be forearm. And then we've got, and obviously, we've got, let's just zoom in here. Oh, see, look, my bones are outside of my body. Wait, are they? I'm in pose mode. Why? Can I do this? No. But can I do this? No. Can I do this? Yes. Let's just move these ever so slightly back. They're really, really need to be inside them hands. Emotional ambiguity, huh? I don't know. I feel like emotional specificity is more powerful. Thumb. 0.01. Thumb. 0.02. Learn the names of the fingers. Index. 0.01. Index. 0.02. Index, 0.03. Riveting content, Isaac. Riveting content. I'll become the NPC stream that I always wanted to be. Not really. What is up with those NPC streams anyway? They're so wild. Like, I know that people have wildly different values than me, but I just can't imagine, like, spending money like that, right? Like, spending money on, you know, throwing money at a person who doesn't, like, even pay attention. Why? Why would you do such a thing? I don't get it. That's why I don't want to be, like, a huge dreamer, because I feel like I would be extorting people, right? What am I giving? What am I giving people? What am I providing? Nothing. Oh, you know what this phone's called? The thigh bone. Hell yeah. And the calf bone. And the foot bone. And the toe bone. Look at that! NPC streams that things I'll never understand. Like, for me, I hate things that get too repetitive because it irritates me. But I still don't understand how people like it. I read your message, but then the internet cut out. Man, the VOD is gonna have, like, so much secret content. Secret content, secret content. This VOD is gonna have so much secret content. Lol. Reconnection successful. Let's go. Get that bitrate back up there. You still don't understand how people like it. I mean, I feel like you have to be a particular kind of lonely, you know? You have to kind of be interested in people. In a way that can't be satisfied or isn't being satisfied by real life people, you know?
Ugh. What to do is make all of our controller bones and set up our IK constraints. Basically, what you need to know is there are two types of bones that we're making right now. We have deforming bones, like all of these ones, that are going to actually be deforming our mesh. And the controller bones aren't going to be deforming our mesh. They're just going to be controlling these other bones to make posing a little easier. Okay?
Interesting.
And when I say IK, I mean inverse kinematics.
Inverse kinematics. The hell is that?
By default, everything is set up to work with forward kinematics, which is basically like when you move the parent, the children will move. If you wanted to pose a bending leg, you would have to start with the highest one in the chain you want to move, like that, and move down one at a time, like this. What IK lets you do is start with a child and kind of designate a certain amount of parent bones to move along with it. So it's a situation where a child bone can affect its parents, okay?
I guess it's one of those things that would take a while to understand for me. I get it if the NPCs are, like, saying multiple lines of an anime or a game. I don't know. It might also just be, like, novelty, right? Oh, look, I can make this person react. But I think there's a deeper loneliness there. Like, if it was just, like, this person on the internet will do things for money. You know, everybody's doing that. But it's the fact that there's so repetitive and mundane things. It's that idea of an NPC, right? You're portraying a character in the game of life. It's kind of sad for the people doing it too.
It kind of goes backwards. Okay, so we can start setting up our IK. Just make sure you're in edit mode for this. And the first thing we're going to do right here is I'm just going to extend a bone out like that, and you want to disconnect this bone with Alt P and clear parent, okay?
All right. By the way, he's got his armature in a separate collection, and he's turned off his... I guess it's fine. Hey, do you know this one? My Favorite Things. A good song. Ah, see the naming procedure. All right, and then select it. Separate. Wait, is that what I wanted? Alt-P, clear parent. That's what I wanted.
And now you can move this anywhere you want. I am going to leave it in the same spot right here. And I'm going to rename that IK.leg. And this is going to be the IK controller for our leg. Next, we need a target bone for our leg. So I'm going to select the knee right here and extrude on the Y axis also. Alt.
Imagine revolutionizing the NPC formula to be better, like redeeming this, make them say an over-the-top line, and they change it again and again. The same tone and vibe, but it's creative. Kind of good for promoting some of your voice work or acting. A chance to engage with the community in a way. Well, this is what I'm saying. Like, I'm sure people have done similar things. I mean, even I'm doing similar things with, like, you know, the Ubu redeems and all that. You literally just summarized what streaming is about at some channels. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I think it's the simplicity and repetition and disconnect that is the point, maybe, the draw, because you're not looking for, you know, somebody with opinions. You're looking to live out that fantasy of controlling someone, I guess. Kind of sad as well. Give me a bone.
P, clear parent, and I'm going to rename that target dot leg. And basically what this target bone does, it lets us control where the knee is pointing, okay? I am actually going to move this one towards the tip of the toe because that is the direction we're going to want our knee to point. So we're...
Sounds fucked up for me, but I guess I'm seeing the appeal. Yeah, and... You know, this is what I have been saying. It's like, if you have that particular brand of powerlessness, and loneliness is kind of powerlessness, right? Social powerlessness, right? If you have that kind of particular brand of loneliness, you're looking for something to control, something to feel like you can manipulate and exercise your agency over. Exercising your agency over something is quite good. But it's kind of like get out there and touch grass, please. But in a broader sense, like, don't just touch grass, you know, create something, make your impact on the world, talk to someone, empathize with someone, feel how someone else's story can change you, and you'll start to notice when your story changes other people. And that's so important because one of the things that we as a society need the most of all is someone to listen, you know, someone to understand us. And it's so hard with streams and Twitter and whatever being so one-sided, right? All of the power is in the poster or in the streamer, right? I'm yelling out into the Twitter void, and my feelings are valid and real, but there's not really a good way for anyone to express a deeper level of understanding and for them to demonstrate that my ideas have changed them as a person. Same thing with streaming, right? Like, I'm streaming here. I'm spending hours and tons of effort and all this stuff streaming, but, you know, who knows who it's reaching. And, yeah, man. Stuff.
We're gonna do the same thing for the arm now. So you can just select this wrist right here, extrude on the Y axis, Alt P, clear parent, and I'm going to rename this IK.arm, select the
spam, donate the hot dog emoji. Does that mean I have to eat a hot dog? Is that what that emoji means? Is that how NPC streams works? Now I have to be hot dog? Sounds interesting, Ray says, as the stream decides that it's not interesting enough. Well, I don't actually have a hot dogs. Wait, hold up. Wild. Your message still came through. So I do have to eat it, huh? How did it come through? How is that possible? Yes, you have to eat the hot dog, but you're free on how you eat the hot dog. Sounds like it's going to be a lot of hot dogs. Hello. Reconnection successful. Does that mean we're back? Ray, did you hear me say hello when it reconnected? Boy, howdy, this is just wild. Who knew that streaming could be so tough? Welcome back. Did you hear me say hello? Stream reconnection. I'm wondering when it says stream reconnect, is that actually when the stream reconnects? Who knows? Nope. Okay, cool. Cool. All right. Yeah, fine. Cool. Alt P, clear parent. Well, hello, Ray. Good to see you once again. So I do have to eat the hot dog. I see. Sounds like a lot of hot dogs. But I'm free in how I eat the hot dog. I just take a little nibble. What if you do the thing like the championship hot dog eater guy and you just down the entire hot dog? Dip it in some water to make the bun shrink, and then just done. Lunch complete. Do you remember when they had like eating competitions on TV? On TV! Some peeps do the Glizzy Gobbler method. Is that where that... Yeah, like the idea that a hot dog is called a glizzy. I have to know where that comes from. I have to know. Glizzy Gobbler meme. The original Glizzy Gobbler, one of the best proto-internet videos. Is this guy... Glizzy Gobbler mean origin. Glizzy is a slang term for hot dogs. The origin is unknown. Existed in various regions around the U.S., including Washington, D.C., and Alabama, prior to appearing online. Ever since I learned that people in D.C. call the hot dogs glizzies, can't get over the fact that a D.C. rapper really named himself Chai Hot Dog. Okay, so it was a real word. It was a real word on the internet. And then in July 2020, the Glizzy Gladiators, if you can fit most of the hot dog in your mouth, you're a Glizzy Gladiator. Glizzy time. This is absolutely ridiculous. But it's kind of funny, right? That's how the internet works. Like, there's some regional joke, but then it becomes everybody's joke. Love disconnect in the middle of middle of a story. Reconnect. Disconnect. Boo. The glizzy's got me. Honestly, I think I'm being rate limited. Like, it doesn't cut out nearly as much when I'm on my phone. It doesn't cut it out at all when I'm on my phone. Maybe it's that backup internet strat, right? Reconnection successful. What up?
Elbow, and when the elbow bends, it's going to be pointing down here. So I'm going to extrude that on the Z axis. Alt P, clear parent, and I'm just going to drag it down right there. And I'm also going to rename it target.arm. So the.
Hello. The glizzy's got me. Glizzy kills. Very, very powerful glizzy kill. Let's extrude this on the Z axis, shall we? Boom. Select. Alt. Clear that parent. Clear that parent. I love that the internet is basically an amalgamation of tons of inside jokes and regional jokes and, like, who the hell calls a hot dog a glizzy? People in Washington, D.C., apparently. But then, it became a universally renowned name for a thing, right? And we named this target.arm. I'm keeping his naming scheme for now because I don't know if IK plus target, like, will link them up, right? And this needs to be IK.arm. My target.leg. Oh God, my target.leg. Now where does yacht come from? Ooh, good question. Let's look it up. Gyat meaning. Gyat is a slang for goddamn. Oh, yeah, like goddamn. Strong excitement, surprise, or admiration. What the hell? The coded meaning behind gyat on TikTok. Reject is just fine. The meaning is pretty straightforward. It's simply a shortened version of goddamn. There you go. Yeah, damn. Scheme ba da ba. Learn American slang. You thought it meant ass? Well, I think it's because it's like stick your gya out for the Rizzler, right? I think it can be misinterpreted as ass because it says that you're supposed to say it in response to seeing an attractive person, right? So if you are saying gyats, you're probably looking at an ass. Yeah. But I imagine the memes have kind of changed the meaning a little bit.
The way I've been doing this, this is just one method. There are many ways you could set this up, okay? And in a future tutorial, I will go over a few more options for more advanced IK rigs. So the only other controller bone I would like to add is a root bone. And so I'm gonna hit Shift A. It should just appear at your 3D cursor right there. And I'm just gonna open up the N side panel and change the length of this so it's a little smaller. And I'm also going to rotate this using Active Element. I'm gonna rotate that a negative 90 degrees like that, and I'm also
okay. Let's make sure we're doing this right.
Going to right A, it should just appear at your 3D cursor right there. And I'm just going to open up the N side panel and change the length of this so it's a little smaller. And I'm also going to rotate this using Active Element. I'm going to rotate that a negative 90 degrees like that. And I'm also going to reset the roll. Basically, the idea behind the root bone is it's something for all of our bones to be parented to, so that when we move the root bone, all of the other bones will follow it. So you can select all of the bones that aren't parented to anything. So that's going to be all of our...
Hold up. Buddy, you're slinging your way around. Slinging your way downtown. Okay.
Controller bone. Many ways you could set this up. IK Shift A, it should just appear at your 3D cursor right there. And I'm just going to open up the N side panel and change the length of this so it's a little smaller. And I'm also going to rotate this using Active Element. I'm going to rotate that a negative 90 degrees like that. And I'm also going to reset the roll. Basically, the idea behind the root bone is it's something for all of our bones to be parented to, so that when we move the root bone, all of the other bones will follow it. So you can select all of the bones that aren't parented to anything. So that's going to be all of our controller bones, so the targets and the IK bones. And also this spine bone right here, which is the top of the bone chain for all of our deforming bones. So we can select that too, and then select the root last, Control P, and keep offset in this.
Hey, let's do that. So select target bone, select IK bone, and select spine bone, and select controller bone last, P, no, control P, keep offset, control P, set the parent, alt P, delete the parent. Okay.
It is helpful for if you want to rotate the entire body or if you want to make your character jump, things like that. So next what I'm going to do is set up the IK constraints. So to do that, you want to go into pose mode like that.
All right. We finally got... Finally got all the bones built. that we're only halfway through this tutorial. Is this gonna be a long tutorial? It is, isn't it? And this bone, we need to name this bone correctly. What do you name the bone? Base? Yeah, let's call it base. Look at this. Look at this guy. He's really coming along. We did a lot of work on the model itself, too, to make it more functional. Yeah. And we're disconnected once again. Well, let's wait till we reconnect. But this might be a good place to stop. Because... We can set up our IK constraints and then start doing working through the issues next time. Should I take a screenshot of this to act as a thumbnail? Yeah, maybe I should. Can we turn off the bone names? Axes. Welcome to chat room. Oh god, it disconnected twice. Blah 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 blah. Alright. I'm taking a screenshot. Beautiful. Man, you know, it's like GIMP is so good, but it takes forever to set up. So I end up just using whatchamacallit. End up using other photo programs for simpler things. Right. Are we back? We back? Are we back? Back again. I took a screenshot for my next thumbnail or whatever. All right. I think this is a good place to stop. And as I suspected, my streaming energy is running dry. So why don't we... Oh, it's been a while. Can I set up the... No. We're just gonna turn off the tutorial and we'll keep this up. Well, I go find someone to raid. Jesus. What is going on Twitch these days? I pop in to Twitch and it's like boobs. Guess people like that kind of thing. Okay. Can I do this from here? Let's do an experiment, shall we? I'm going to go to the creator dashboard. And do raid Nicula live. Test this. A raid has been created. Hell yeah. Thank you to the few people who are able to stick around and chat through all this tomfuckery. I wouldn't be surprised if a ton of people have my stream open. Just the player is down and they haven't opened the tab window again. And John Coltrane is playing a song called BJ. What a way to go out. Well, my name is Isaac Konzi. Thank you so much for joining. We're going to go raid Benicula with my tiny amount of viewers because my stream keeps messing up. And you know what this means. Stay safe, stay classy. Don't let the bitcoins bite. Is that what I said? Is that my outro? Is that my outro phrase? Anyway, I'll catch you next time. Farewell.